Hi, I'm Kathy Kautsky, and I'm on the piano faculty at Lawrence University. I'm delighted that you're listening, and I wanted to tell you a tiny bit about the background for this video. I'm going to start with a little bit of personal history. I think that as long as I've known that I would be a musician, I've worried a little bit about the fact that being a musician seems like such a selfish thing to do. I worry about that less now as I feel more and more like music is absolutely essential to human existence. But I still worry that we as musicians are awfully isolated from an awful lot of the misery in the world. And so when my lovely friend Kim Kashkashian, who's one of the world's great violists, started Music for Food in Boston about 10 years ago, I was absolutely delighted when she asked me if Lawrence might want to participate. And for the last number of years, Lawrence has indeed used large ensemble concerts in November to raise money and collect food to donate to St. Joe's Food Pantry in Appleton via Music for Food. The lovely thing about Music for Food is that they take absolutely no part of anyone's donations for administrative costs. Everything gets processed through them and then sent directly to whatever the community's food pantry of choice might be. And so your donations today will go through Music for Food and then end up right at St. Joe's in Appleton. My students have worked incredibly hard to make this video. Their lives in spring have obviously been far from what they imagined they would be, and many of them have found them practicing on less than wonderful pianos in places they never imagined they would be living. And yet they've really managed to produce wonderful, wonderful music. And so I'm just delighted to share that with you, and with the music, to share the hope that we and you together can take some tiny step to help allay a very small bit of the suffering that's now rampant in Appleton, in the United States, and obviously in the world at large. So thank you for your help.
My name is Maria Santos, and I'm a senior at Lawrence studying piano performance with a minor in pedagogy. Just a little bit about me. I'm originally from New Jersey, but now I'm finishing up my last year at Lawrence. And this fall, I'll be heading to TCU to earn my master's in music in piano pedagogy. This piece is Beethoven's Sonata Opus 26, just the first movement, which is a theme in variations. Thank you.
is Hung, and I'm from Vietnam, and I'm currently a junior at Lawrence University, majoring in piano performance in the studio of Kathy Kowski. And the piece I'm going to play today is Tchaikovsky's Dumka, and I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Hello, my name is Joe Komen, and I'm a freshman at Lawrence University studying classical and jazz piano performance. The piece I'll be playing for you today is Johann Sebastian Bach's Prelude and Fugue in C minor. Now, Bach wrote one Prelude and Fugue in every major and minor key twice for a total of 48 Prelude and Fugues. And while it is my hope to learn them all someday, eventually, here is Prelude and Fugue in C minor.
And I'm a freshman at Lawrence University. I'm majoring in piano performance, and I'm also thinking to minor in piano pedagogy. I'm from Japan, and I'm in Japan right now with my family. Today I'm going to be playing Chopin's Etude, Opus 10, No. 4 in C sharp minor. This piece is really exciting, so I hope you can enjoy. Thank you.
Hi everyone, my name is Ashley Ondua, and I am a freshman at Lawrence Conservatory. Today I'll be playing a piece by Clara Schumann, and it is titled Three Romances, Opus 11, Number 2, on Dante and Allegro. I'm from Cameroon, and I moved to the United States when I was 10 years old with the dream of becoming a pianist. Growing up, I did not really see a lot of female pianists. Females usually sang or played the flute, but they were never really found at piano recitals and piano concerts. Having the desire to come to the United States and better my piano craft and just learn more about music, I was inspired by female composers like Clara Schumann, because it was, especially in her time, it was unheard of or not really common for females to compose and be pianists and just be virtuoso pianists. So I really find her inspiring, and I hope that you guys enjoy this piece. Thank you and enjoy. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Noah Vasquez, and I'm a junior at Lawrence University, majoring in piano performance with a collaborative emphasis. To tell you a little bit about myself, I actually grew up in Zurich, Switzerland, and only came to the U.S. for college. My father works there as an opera singer, and I think growing up around singing is actually what inspired me to pursue collaborative piano, as I have a really great interest in collaborating with vocalists especially, and it's something I'm hoping to continue pursuing in my master's. The piece you'll hear today is by a French composer named Maurice Ravel, who lived around the turn of the 20th century. It's the first piece in his set titled Miroir, which literally means mirrors or reflections. So these are depictions of images that he tried to capture in music. This piece is the first in the set, titled Noctuelle, which is the French word for nocturnal moths. Now, before the piece, I will leave you with a line of poetry that actually inspired this piece by Léon Paul Farc. The nocturnal moths, in their barns, launch themselves clumsily into the air, going from one perch to another. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Shirley, and I am a sophomore majoring in piano performance and English from Lawrence University. Today I'm going to play a piece by Tan Dun. It's a piece called Floating Clouds from 8 Sketches of Watercolor. I really love the really flowy imagery and lines of this piece, and I hope you enjoy those softness and dreamy feelings as much as I do.
Hi, my name is Nick Siminski, and I'm a senior at Lawrence, double majoring in chemistry and piano performance. I'm going to be playing to you today two pieces from a much longer work called Goyescas by Enrique Granados. Goyescas as a whole tells a story, and this first work, Maiden in the Nightingale, fits in sort of the middle of the story, where a maiden is sort of lamenting at her lover's pride, which ultimately, eventually, leads to his death.
Thank you.
This next piece I'll be playing for you, El Pelele, is based on a Spanish tradition in which the women of Madrid would go out around Carnival and they would make a giant stuffed mannequin out of old clothes and straw, and they would throw it in the air while singing about how terrible men are. So you can hear some of the humor and mirth behind this tradition, and Granados really makes me throw my hands around the piano.